And action. Hi, this is David at hownowvideo.com. And in today's tutorial, I'm going to talk about doing a two-camera shoot. Now, there's times when you want to use two cameras running constantly for an event such as a concert or a play, where you let the one camera, the wide shot, run unattended. And you will use your close-up camera to follow the action. And it's important to be able to synchronize the two cameras. So what you need to do is to start the cameras running together, set your white balances so the cameras look similar in color, and either use a clapperboard or simply just clap your hands. And this will allow you to synchronize the two video sources. Now, you can use the camera's sound, or you can use a third party recording device. And in this case, I'm using a lapel mic, a wireless Sony lapel mic, and I'm connected to this flash recorder. And this is the Sony PCM-D50, which works really well. And that's how they do it in Hollywood. They record the audio source separate from the film, and the clapper allows them to synchronize the closing of the clapper with the spike that occurs in the audio track. And we use the same method here, where we're using this clapper or clapping your hands to synchronize two cameras. Now, if you can afford it, buy two identical cameras. You'll get the best white balance matches that way. Or if you have two different cameras, you might have to work with setting your white balances so that they both look similar. All right, let's go in and edit these two, and I'll show you how to synchronize the two cameras based on the clap. And then we'll bring in the third audio source as well. All right, here we are in Premiere Pro CS4, and this should work in earlier versions of Premiere Pro. But if you look at the left here, I have my raw sources. I have my close camera, my wide camera, and my audio track, which is an optional thing you can do. You can record your audio in a separate device like the PCM-D50 that I showed you. So we'll start by dragging the close shot into the timeline. And we're going to next drag the wide shot into the timeline. Now I'm going to expand the two audio areas down here because we're trying to synchronize the clapping. So I'll get it close. I'll see where the thing shuts. And then I'll zoom in. So make sure these two cameras are really synchronized. Now I can see that they're a little off. They're about a frame off. So I will drag this one to the right. And now you can see they line up pretty close. And if I toggle the videos on and off, you can see that they're synchronized. I can use the left arrow on my keyboard to go back one frame and then toggle on and off. And you can see that they are synchronized. So that's why it's important to use either clapping your hands or some sort of clapper board. Now, we're going to drag in the optional audio track right here. I'll drag that down. And I will kick it over a bit and try to line that up again. I'll zoom in really tight here. and I will move it over a bit. Sometimes you'll have one frame or so where it doesn't quite line up, but that is actually still close enough. Now I'll turn off the other audio sources and just listen to the third audio source as I play. And action. Hi, this is David at hownowvideo.com. All right, so that is a quick tutorial on how to synchronize two different cameras with each other and then with a third optional audio source. Now, the two cameras I've used today are both Panasonics, but they're not exactly the same camera. So you might notice in the video that there is a slight difference in the way the wall is being illuminated. The skin tones are slightly different as well, even though these are set on the same white balance. So, like I said in the introduction, it's good to have two identical cameras if you really want to nail it. And then you can use your multi-tracking technique in Premiere Pro to switch between these two cameras as the video plays. So that's a quick tutorial on how to synchronize two cameras and also bring in an audio track. Thanks for watching.